Hey guys, it's Mark. This is the Mark Wilson Sports Show. It is Saturday. I hope you guys all have a good Saturday. And alrighty, game four, Cavs versus the Celtics. I'm going with my Celtics. I am believing the Celtics are going to win. I have to believe the Celtics. I think they're going to win tonight, and then they're going to lose next game, and it's going to be 4-1 season series is over. And that's good for the Celtics. Like, at least they made the playoffs this year. That's good. And they had a deal with Cleveland this whole series. That's a good experience for the young players like Marcus Smart, Avery Bradley, Kelly Olynyk, Jared Sullinger, all those. And then we're going to have a really good draft. We got a lot of draft picks. Danny Ainge is going to do something in the offseason. I have a feeling we're going to get a really good free agent. And alright, let's look at news, top news sports. Oh, and I heard that Clemson linebacker Vaughn Beasley, because he has off the field troubles. Patriots, pick him up. He's like another Jamie Collins. I think if he can develop, he'll be another Jamie Collins. And because he has off the field troubles, and he failed the drug test at the scouting combine, he got dropped to the second round rather than first round pick. And so I wish the Celtics will pick him. Jesus. Floyd Mayweather Pacquiao tickets are right now more than 10,000. There's more than 10,000 tickets sold for Saturday night's fight. Oh, for the weigh-in. That's just for the weigh-in. For Friday's weigh-in, there's been 10,000 tickets. That's crazy. Alright, let's look at news. Bruce Jenner, I guess he really came out and he really wants to be a girl. That is very weird. What a weirdo. Is there a video on this? I'm definitely, oh my Lanta, there is a video. We are putting this on here. Jesus, Bruce Jenner, what a weirdo. We got an ad, I'm sorry guys. No. Jesus, does he really want to be a woman?
In the Summer Games of 1976 in Montreal, his victory in the Olympic decathlon earned Bruce Jenner the title of World's Greatest Athlete. His record-setting performance defeating the USSR's Nikolai Avalon.
We see the force.
Yeah.
You see what?
A confused person at that time, running away from my life, running away from who I was.
That running away is over. Jenner, in an interview that aired Friday night, telling Diane Sawyer of ABC News of life as a transgender person, transitioning to a woman.
Are you a woman?
Yes, for all intents and purposes, I am a woman. I was not genetically born that way.
What the heck?
As of now, have all the male parts and all that kind of stuff, but we still identify as female. And that's very hard for Bruce Jenner to say.
The 65-year-old Jenner, referred to as he during the interview at Jenner's suggestion, told Sawyer of an inner torment that has lasted a lifetime.
I would say I've always been very confused with my gender identity since I was this big. I tried to explain it because I've had all my kids sitting in that chair. And I've tried to explain it to them this way. God's looking down, making little Bruce. Okay? And he gave me all these wonderful qualities. And then at the end, when he's just finishing, he goes, wait a second. We got to give him something. Everybody has stuff in their life that they have to deal with. You know, what are we going to give him? You know, hey, let's give him the soul of a female. And let's see how he deals with that.
What a weirdo.
So here I am stuck. And I hate the word, girl stuck in a guy's body. I hate that terminology.
Why?
I'm me. I'm a person. And this is who I am. my brain is much more female than it is male.
Jenner first thought about transitioning in the 1980s, some 30 years ago.
God, I've started on hormones. I did it almost 5 years.
Married three times, Jenner spoke to Sawyer of being sexually attracted only to women.
Sexuality is who you are personally attracted to, who you, you know, turns you on, male or female. But gender identity is how to do with who you are as a person and your soul and who you identify with inside.
A third marriage to the former Kris Kardashian would transform Jenner's public identity. With paparazzi fueled by the show Keeping Up with the Kardashians on the trail, Jenner was photographed at a doctor's appointment for Adam's apple reduction. Crisis.
Heart's pounding. And I thought, wouldn't the easiest thing to be right now, and I can see where people get to that, just go in the room, got a gun, boom, you know, pain's over, it's done, you know, go to a better place. And I thought, nah, I can't do something like that. I mean, I want to know how this story ends. You know, how does my story end?
Jenner told Diane Sawyer of a plan to drop from public view and reemerge later as a transgender woman.
I just can't pull the curtain any longer, okay? Bruce lives a lie. She is not a lie.
On this journey, Jenner already has support from family members and from a somewhat unlikely source, the Ukrainian Jenner beat for the gold medal back in 1976, Nikolai Avalov, telling ABC News, every person has his own choice. All people have the right to do what they want.
What I'm doing is going to do some good, and we're going to change the world. I really firmly believe that.
Hey, then?
Everybody's struggling with what this is.
That is me. That is her.
And people have to know that you can want to identify as a woman and still
kick butt.
Okay, then. Next story. Bruce Jenner is a woman, I guess. Okay. All right. I do really don't want the Spurs to win the playoffs. I really don't want the Spurs to win. Oh, Paul Pierce had a night last night. He had 18 points. I heard he had a second half. He put 16 points in. He went 4-for-5 at field goal. And at 3-point line, he had 4-for-5. That is crazy stuff. Rangers 4-1. They ended the series with the Penguins. They are on to the next round. That is awesome. I want the Rangers to win the Stanley Cup. That is great. Claude Julien is hired as the Edmonton Oilers manager, general manager. He was the Bruins general manager. Good luck out there, buddy. Shea Weber will miss the remainder of the Blackhawks series. That's bad for the Nashville Predators. He is their best defenseman. That is not good. Let's see. Boom, 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 boom. Josh Hamilton, ready, is getting traded to the Texas Rangers. It's a near deal. That is crazy. I think he wasn't he on the Rangers before he was on the Angels? I don't know. I have to look that up before, but that's crazy. Puig out with a hamstring, and Pacquiao, it's all about Mayweather-Pacquiao. I'm going with Mayweather still. I'm going with my money team. They're winning it. Derrick Rose is like, I don't know. He's crazy, man. He has like what? He already had 4 knee surgeries and like the last few games he's put up like 25 points or something. Some stupid in the playoffs. It's like, it's crazy. Floyd Mayweather, history of violence. Let's watch this video. This is going to be an ad. Because you had to be a big shot. Danger.
718.
The Mets win it!
This is a rivalry made for the headlines. Sunday Night Baseball, Mets Yankees at 8. Baseball rules on ESPN.
Jamel, you laid out some of the economics, but just the history of boxing, the way it's decentralized. I mean, how realistic is it for us to expect for this sport to make a stand on this issue, given its economics and given its own history over all of these issues?
I don't think it's realistic at all. And that's the position that not just boxing, but a lot of leagues are put in. As much as they sometimes give lip service to even making moral considerations when it comes to, be it a Floyd Mayweather or any other of these type of decisions, when it gets down to the nitty gritty, they're going to make a financial decision. And in boxing, in an individual sport, and especially given the nature of the sport, I think that plays into it as well. And you know, there are a lot of guys in boxing that have not had a clean pass, have had far from it. I think that they've rationalized it to the point where they find it acceptable to not punish somebody like Floyd Mayweather.
Tim, you paint a picture in your article coming out on Wednesday of this boxer who has an incredible self-constructed world around him through his wealth that he has accomplished by ferociously training and succeeding in the ring, and lives in there with this ferocity and a laser focus.
And, Bob, I think that insulation that he's created within this world has, you know, it's created a couple of things that are very important. And one of them is deference, and the other one is loyalty. And I think that's kind of the root of a lot of this, is that, you know, if someone is seen as violating one or both of those principles.
Oh, I think we get it. That Floyd Mayweather has been in prison for violence, and we get that. All right. That's crazy. Hamilton is going to the Rangers. I don't know what they don't. It's still pending. They're still working on the deal. That is crazy. Okay, because he just signed that huge deal with the Angels like 2 years ago. It was like $100 million contract. And Jameis Winston is still number. They still say he's gonna be the number one pick in the draft. And that's it right now. This is the Mark Wilson Sports Show, and I hope you guys all have a good Saturday. Let's hope our Celtics win this game for tonight. We need this win. And all right, I'll talk to you guys later. All right, bye.